Good afternoon, traders. It's Bill Baruch with Blue Line Futures, and it's your Midday Market Minute. The NASDAQ crossed 7,200 today before pulling back just a bit. Came in with about 10 ticks or 10 points of its all-time high. Now, it's back to about unchanged on the session. However, the S&P is holding ground up 10 points. The banks are on fire today as yields continue to inch up ahead of next week's FOMC meeting. We talk about the yields and how they react ahead of those meetings on our Morning Express. Check that out. We talked about it yesterday and today. Now, the S&P is out above major three-star resistance, 2755, 2756. A close above here is a breakout, and the next target is our rare major four-star level, about 2% higher. Check it out on the Morning Express. Moving on to crude oil, builds across the board today. Gasoline, crude oil, distillates, all builds. You have production coming up in the lower 48 states of 35,000 barrels per day last week. Now, this is a bearish report. It's almost as bearish as it can get, considering how evenly spread these builds were across the board. However, crude oil has not made a new low against yesterday. Watch for that level. This can mean that the selling has been exacerbated. We talked about it yesterday. Yesterday being a consolidation, major three-star resistance up at 66, held very well. We talked about that yesterday. Don't look for more than that. Trade off of that level. It's worked out. The game plan in that sense has worked very well. Now, on this low end, you do not want to see a new low. So with a bearish report today, as bearish as it was, if you don't see a new low, that can actually turn into bullishness, and we could actually work our way higher into the end of the week. So look for that. The dollar remains down, and you're seeing the metals wake up a bit. You got gold and silver trading higher, but copper is on a 2 to 3 day tear higher. Watch for copper trading by 3.25. This right here, this was a supply problem several years ago for copper. That's why it traded so much lower. But now on the other end of it, it's the same sort of problem we're seeing with crude oil, where you've seen supply come off the market. Now supply is off the market, and copper is ripping up. So watch for copper here, 3.25. But we really like gold and silver being very, very constructive over the past 24 hours. Silver looks like it wants to get back above 17 bucks. So watch for that. And we talked about in the Morning Express that gold and silver, this constructive price action, is great to see ahead of the Fed minutes or ahead of the next week's Fed meeting. And if we get a dovish hike, the metals can really capitalize from that. Give us a call. We're here to talk about all this on the board. 312-278-0500. You can email us info@bluelinefutures.com. Check our website for updates. And you can sign up for a free trial of our research on our website. But remember, futures trading involves substantial risk of loss. It's not suitable for all investors. Thank you.